me and a friend of mine knew the Elvis impersonator. We got to talking about doing the Elvis Michael Jackson show, and doing a tribute, you know, and so you know, king of rock and roll, king of pop, you know, kind of go hand in hand, you know. I don't want to be a tiger, 'cause tigers belong to a room. I don't want to be a lion, 'cause lions ain't the kind of love. And so after he performed, I paused the music. As I said to him, just relax, just kind of groove into it, you know, kind of like, you know, move your hips a little bit, move your feet, you know, pivot back and forth, you know, stuff like that. I was teaching him how to use your whole section, you know, your whole stage, your whole dance floor, you know, like just own it. You gotta, you really gotta own, say, you know, the stage, you know, for it to be believable. Techniques of getting your nerves down, and you know, and like looking past the crowd, you know, sometimes you can look at the crowd, but to relax, you know, just kind of concentrate what's behind them, you know.
So like when you're performing, kind of look past the audience, you know, like you know, look at a tree over there, you know. Like sometimes I'll be like going like that, or be like pointing. I've been pointing this way, but I was looking that way. It's kind of like don't try to look at the audience. You know, sometimes look at the audience, but you know.
It breaks my heart to see other kids rejecting people with disabilities. It really does. But. Why I want to be there for them, and I want to be there to, you know, help them, you know, be the person he wants to be the Elvis impersonator he wants to be, you know, and it was a lot of fun. I hope to work with him more, do more shows with him, and just, you know, maybe become a duo, and, you know, do like a Kings of Music kind of line of shows.